September 2025, and we're looking at the north-south connector for the development of the M2, the no level crossings and no intersection highway stretching from Waterloo Corner to the southern suburbs. And if we come in closer, the key places of interest are Darlington, which is one end of the Torrens to Darlington, Glandore, which is the point where the tunnels between Glandore and Darlington occur, then to Hilton, and then to Thebarton, and we start the video at this intersection by the center, and this will show us what's going to happen here if we pull back. Torrens to Darlington actually starts on Port Road and we'll now descend down to ground level to look at the traffic as it is.
Thebarton at the northern end of the dual tunnels for the northern tunnels of the Torrens to Darlington M2 development, and you can see here the West Thebarton Hotel, which will be demolished, and behind me the Thebarton Centre. And at this point, the M2 will be coming out of the tunnels and crossing over the River Torrens, and this centre behind me will be demolished. And the tunnel will be bored with a second run of the tunnel boring machine going back south again.
And what we have is that the tunnels are going to have a structure called a launch box, a tunnel machine launch box, which will be 35 meters down underground, and so a hole 35 meters deep has to be dug here. And in the northern set of tunnels there'll be one boring machine which will go from here, from Hilton, underneath the houses and businesses and roads to get to Thebarton, where there'll be another box, tunnel boring box, but a smaller one, because what happened here is that the boring machine will be broken into its sections, and these sections will then be turned around and then assembled, and in the tunnel will then bore back again and complete the second tunnel and return here back to Hilton. This diagram from the northern approach tunnel of the motorway in Auckland, New Zealand, shows how the tunnel boring machine from the first tunnel is broken into segments and then pivoted around and then is taken forward to start to dig the second tunnel going back along the directions came. So this is where the other end of the tunnel will be. At the moment, nothing's been demolished. So this is the official Torrens to Darlington map showing the development here at the northern end of the northern tunnels, and the point where I came off in the video previously is actually where the south road will go. And so the south road at this point will become divided road, and this is where the Thebarton Centre currently is located. And that is basically where the M2 is emerging out of the tunnels, which are down 35 metres and coming up to the surface. At this point, there's no room to do any off-ramps from those going up or any on-ramps for those going down here at Thebarton. In fact, if you look close to the M2, you'll see that what you can do here at the start of the Torrens is you can come off the up M2 to get onto South Road, or on the other side coming from up here at Grange Road, Manton Street, vehicles from Grange and from Adelaide CBD coming along Manton Street can get onto the M2 by going down onto the M2 into the tunnels. The implication is that people coming from the north wanting to go to the Brickswork Shopping Centre or to the Thebarton Oval for the Adelaide Crows actually we'll have to exit from the M2 coming from the north up here at Port Road on the current exit and come up and cross over Port Road, and the M2 development, the Torrens to Darlington, actually is widening this section of road, which currently is only two lanes. And now it's going to be made into five lanes at that point, it would seem, according to the diagram. And here it's being reduced down to three lanes. So what they're doing is separating the through traffic, the M2 traffic, from the local traffic. And so they're making it easier for the local traffic to move around. So this will be much less congested. The upside of this whole structure is that the local traffic can move around freely, whilst the through traffic of the M2 can proceed at 80 kilometres an hour without any problems. The major issue, of course, was here at the River Torrens, this cemetery, which is seen as untouchable. The other difficulty too was how to join up a tunnel onto a above ground structure. Tunnels which are down at 30 metres are being brought up to the surface, and they chose not to go underneath the River Torrens but to go above the River Torrens. And so this now is the structure for the roads at the northern end of the Torrens to Darlington.